In today's digital photography world, it's easy to accumulate tons and tons of pictures. If you're an iCloud user, it doesn't take real long until you use up the free space that Apple gives you. Then you're left with a choice. You can buy more space, which granted isn't super expensive, but it's still extra money. Or you can get rid of some photos and free up space. Here's the problem. Let's say you have photos on your computer, on your tablet, on your iPhone. If you delete from one of those places, it deletes them everywhere. They're lost forever. In this video today, I'm going to show you how to save photos to your computer and then delete them from the iCloud, yet you'll still have them. Once they're on your computer, you can transfer them to an external drive, you can transfer them to a USB flash drive, whatever you want to do. My word of caution, though, is if you take them out of iCloud, make sure that you have redundant backup. What's redundant backup? That means you're backing up more than one place. If you use an external drive, use two external drives and back up the same pictures to both drives. Because remember this, all hard drives crash. All hard drives crash. So you want to have redundancy. Or on the other hand, if you have online backup, like I use and recommend Carbonite, then if they're on your computer, Carbonite will back them up. Regardless, you need backup once you take them out of iCloud. Again, in this video, I'm going to show you how to take them out of iCloud, yet not have them deleted forever. Let's get started. First, we're going to look at Windows machines. For Windows, what we're going to do is we're going to open a browser and we're going to go to iCloud.com. Once we're on the page, we're going to go where it says sign in, and we're going to put in our Apple ID, and then we're going to put in our Apple password. If you've never gone here before, you'll get a two-factor authentication. In my case, on my phone, I got the Apple ID. I tap that, and once I tap that, then it comes up and it gives me a location. I click allow or tap allow, and then it will give me a code to put in on the page that we were looking at a minute ago. This is 574010. Remember that the number changes every time. And I'm going to go back to my browser, and where it asked me to put the number in, I put that in. Then it will ask me, do I want to trust the browser? I click trust. One thing you should know is that many times after there is a browser update, you'll have to go through that process again. Anyway, I'm in iCloud now, and I have some photos that you see. Now I have 14,202 photos, 892 videos. I do not want all of those on my computer. And that's why I'm not using the iCloud app. I don't want everything on. I just want certain things. As an example, I'm going to do this picture with Gus in the bed. He's laying in a bed with sheets. I click on that. Up top, there's a little cloud with a down arrow, and I download it. Now I can click Save As, and I can put it wherever I want. I can change the name. I can put it in Downloads. I can put it in Pictures. I can put it in a special folder. Whatever I want to do, I can do that. And once I've renamed it in this case, I'm going to click Save. Now that's how to do one picture at a time. If you only need one picture, great. But if you're going to try to eliminate some photos from the iCloud so you can either get more space or not have to buy extra space, you can highlight more than one. In this case, I've highlighted five. and it's going to download in a zip format. Once again, I'm telling where I want to save it. And now I'm going to open it. It is zipped, so I have to extract the files from that. So I'm going to click extract. It's going to put it in its own little folder under downloads. And there's a folder. Now I double click that folder, and there's my five pictures. I'm going to change so you can see them. There are the five pictures that I just downloaded. Now I could download 50 pictures at a time, 100 pictures at a time. The more I choose, though, the bigger the zip file is going to be, the longer it's going to take to download, and the longer it will take to extract. Now, I can take those same five pictures and delete them from the iCloud. After I hit the delete button, I'll need to confirm that I actually want to delete them. They're gone from iCloud, but they're on my computer. That's a way to move photos from iCloud to your computer or to your device. Now I could put a USB drive in, I could copy them to there, I could do whatever. Just remember this, backup is very important. Once you take photos out of iCloud, make sure that you have redundant backup. Now let's look at Mac computers. On a Mac, you don't have to go to iCloud because your photos are already on the Mac. So what you want to do is open the gallery, which of course we have an icon down at the bottom. So photos, I open that. There's the same photos that you just saw on the Windows machine. There they are. Now in this case, instead of downloading, I export them. I'm going to go up here to where there's a turkey, and I want to export that picture of the turkey onto my Mac. First, I click on it to highlight it, and then at the top menu, I go up under File and Export. And when I move down to Export, I get another menu, Export One Photo. And now it tells you it's going to be a JPEG. I can include title, keywords, captions, etc., and export. And then I have to pick where I want it to go. In this case, I'm going to pick the desktop, and I'm going to create a new folder, and I'm going to title that folder Photo Test. I'm going to create it, and now I'm going to export that one picture into that album. If I want to download more than one picture, I simply highlight all the pictures I want to download. I'm going to highlight five pictures. And once I have all five pictures highlighted, I go up to File and Export, and it reads Export Five Photos. And I click Export. I'm going to put it in the same folder so I don't have to change anything. And I hit Export again. And now all six pictures are in that same folder. And if I go look at that, I go to the desktop, and there is my photo test folder. I open that, and there are my six pictures. And I can show them as icons and see them. Now they are on my Mac. I could now go back into Photos and delete them from all devices that they were on. Once I have them highlighted, all I have to do is hit the delete key on the keyboard and then confirm that I actually do want to delete them. They're gone from iCloud, but they're on my Mac. The same thing applies. If you're going to keep your photos outside of iCloud, make sure that you have them backed up. Not just once, if they're important especially, not just once, but twice. That's it for this video. I'm John Grubb from 4KCC.com. I hope that you've subscribed to our channel and that you will like this video and share it with other people. Come back often. We're always posting computing-related videos, how to do this, how to do that, stay secure, whatever the case may be. Please come visit us again. And thanks.